tu po tiki kwe I tiki atu I kuku me mai ki te taha tu o te rā. Haere mai, piki mai, haere mai. Ko horahia te whāriki, ki te ihi, ki te wehi, ki te mana, I runga I te marae o te rā. No reira, piki mai, kake mai, haere mai rā.
Please be seated. In a mana, in a reo, in a hui wha, tēnā koutou. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Vice-Chancellor, Pro-Chancellor, Council members, members of the University, special guests, graduands, families and friends, I extend a warm welcome to this, the fourth autumn graduation ceremony for 2011 of the University of Auckland. This week, the University is bestowing a total of 6,579 qualifications on 6,051 students. At this ceremony, degrees will be conferred and diplomas awarded in the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences. A total of 480 in person, plus a further 126 in absentia. It is my great privilege as Chancellor to preside at autumn graduation for a third year. The scale and frequency of graduation ceremonies makes them no less special for the University and me personally than for those of you being capped here today, many for the first time. Graduation is a festive event, rich in history, pomp and colour, with a lively array of contemporary touches. Here in Auckland, our rich mix of cultures and ethnicities is evident in the striking variety of dress and adornments worn by the graduands. Today is one of hard-earned celebration by you, the graduands and diplomates, on your academic accomplishments and by your family and friends who have encouraged and supported you through your studies and who are here to rejoice in your success. The University, represented by the Council and academic staff members seated behind me, and those many staff who control proceedings with remarkable precision, takes equal pleasure at this hugely significant day for each and every one of you. The University of Auckland is the only New Zealand university ranked in the top 1% of the world's universities. Your qualifications will always serve you well in New Zealand and abroad, whether in equipping you for a satisfying career or in leading to more advanced study, or simply as a route to personal and intellectual enrichment. In today's fast-changing world, more than ever, you cannot afford to stop learning. So please keep in mind the enormous range of postgraduate opportunities this university offers. Whatever path you follow, I urge you, as alumni of New Zealand's leading university, always to remember your alma mater. We depend increasingly on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. Your advocacy and influence are vital in encouraging government and the community at large to fund universities so they can generate the knowledge needed to drive a productive and competitive economy and to create a full and satisfying life for New Zealanders. At the same time, philanthropy has become critically important to our university, funding major capital projects, scholarships, and professorial chairs. The crucial contribution of major research universities such as ours is not well understood. Our innovative research is vital for long-term sustainable economic growth and social cohesion. Never more so than in the difficult economic times New Zealand now faces in the wake of the recession and the two Christchurch earthquakes. Universities equip graduates like you, not simply for the jobs of today, but for future careers not yet imagined. Universities need greater investment by government, the commercial sector, and private philanthropy, not less. But that's sufficient for me on the challenges facing academia. For today, unquestionably belongs to you, the graduands, and you are its primary focus. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the enjoyment and excitement of your graduation in May 2011. Our speaker this morning is Mr. Andrew Connolly, a prominent general and colorectal surgeon in Auckland. He is a consultant surgeon at Middlemore Hospital, where he is head of Department of General and Vascular Surgery. Mr. Connolly graduated MBCHB from the University of Auckland in 1987 and was made a fellow of the Royal Australasian College of Surgeons in 1994. After 18 months of formal research under Professor Graham Hill at Auckland Hospital, he spent 2 years in Britain in post-fellowship colorectal surgical training. He has strong interests in surgical training and education and clinical governance and is actively involved in clinical research. In 2009, Mr. Connolly was appointed by the Minister of Health to the Medical Council of New Zealand, and he is the presiding member of the Lotteries Health Research Distribution Committee of the Department of Internal Affairs. He describes himself as a lifelong Liverpool football fan, and he is also an avid amateur military historian, particularly focused on the First World War. Please welcome Mr. Andrew Connolly.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of Council, Dean, faculty, graduands, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for the opportunity of addressing you today. I'm privileged to stand here today to join with you in celebrating your academic success in the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences. It's more years than I frankly care to remember since I sat where you are, but I have absolutely no regrets about the journey I took. My time at medical school gave me friends that are still my closest, gave me a sense of who I was and what sort of doctor I aspired to be. And I know my nursing colleagues felt the same. I'm sure my pharmacy colleagues also felt the same about their schools. Now, of course, the med school is but one part of a much greater faculty. And whilst a once decent car park in Park Road now hosts a massive new block, and the cafe serves real food, which is quite a revelation for us who were there in the 1980s, the importance of what goes on at Park Road and in the various institutions that contribute to the faculty has not diminished over the last quarter century. In fact, it's only increased. You, the graduates of 2011, have achieved a wonderful thing. In your chosen fields, you have met and surpassed a set of standards set not only by the university and your clinical teachers, but in fact by society as a whole. And you have done this in one of the world's leading health faculties, in one of the world's leading universities. And on your behalf, I would acknowledge the leadership that sits on this stage. Having met this standard, you have earned the right to call yourself a health professional. With this right comes a wonderful privilege and a host of responsibilities. That privilege manifests itself in a number of ways. First, it is caring for others. There is no greater public service than to dedicate one's professional life to caring for those less fortunate. At a time in a person's life when they're often at their most vulnerable, at their weakest, and at their sickest, a health professional who displays simple humanity by listening is often never forgotten. Please do not doubt the importance of even the smallest of gestures. You may be wondering why you studied so long and so hard to apparently be judged by small gestures, but remember, it is your global knowledge that allows you to begin to understand just what it means to be sick, Therefore, your small gestures have real understanding behind them, and therefore they are perceived as genuine. Our responsibilities when it comes to caring are legion, but I think they can be summarised quite simply. Most patients, the vast majority, not surprisingly, want to get better. With that desire comes a need for those who care for them to show them respect, to be thorough and professional in their approach. But perhaps most importantly, the patient wants to know that the health professional dealing with them actually cares. The second privilege of being a health professional is to gain an understanding of others. As a nation, we have just commemorated Anzac Day. I'd like to remind you that you are some of the last classes of graduates who will have the privilege of knowing, talking to, and caring for veterans of the Second World War. These people are mainly in the last days of their lives, and many now only want to share a little of what they experienced. I would ask you to take time to listen to them, as they may well tell you things that even their families are unaware of. The tangata whenua of this land, and many of the Pacific peoples represented by you here today, come from cultures steeped in oral tradition. We should all learn from those traditions and take time to listen, especially when the old and the sick wish to talk. A third and great privilege of being a health professional is that we get to spend time with people like you. There is an inherent need to educate our students and each other. Never forget this privilege, because it is also our collective responsibility. Remember, you have all been taught by others. Some were no doubt very good, and there would have been some that were terrible, but all of them at least took the time to teach. As a surgeon, I have the privilege of, on occasions, literally someone holding someone's life in my hands, at least for a period of time. Yet these days, I only intermittently physically cut things. I spend much of my time in the operating theatre training my registrars. When the registrar can do the operation better than me, my teaching has been a success. There is one such registrar in the audience today. Each generation must strive to be better than the last, and I encourage all of you to do better year on year, and I challenge each of you to make the next generation better than you are. Having graduated, having finished years of exams and studies, having done countless hours of, frankly, needless experiments, if you're thinking from the student point of view, of writing up your thesis only to have your supervisor reject it for the fifth time, of sitting at your desk while your mates went to the beach, it's natural to think, no more, never again, I will never again do an exam or read late into the night. Well, unfortunately for health professionals, learning never stops, and we will never lose the need to continue to improve our knowledge and to maintain and improve our professional things. But we should see this as a good thing, for the more we know, the easier our job becomes. This is yet another responsibility, and I suspect it's one that Professor Martin didn't mention on the open day at the faculty all those years ago. All the various councils and colleges that make up the governance of health in New Zealand are geared ultimately towards two goals. The first is a constant improvement and protection of public health and safety. The second is the training and education of the various members of those councils and colleges. Therefore, we must embrace future training, both as pupils and as teachers. I've referred to all of you as having obtained the title health professional. I've not yet defined what a profession is. A profession is simply one that regulates itself, a body that teaches its own, examines its own, and judges its own. And never doubt the importance of these rights, because they are too great privileges. And again, these come with responsibilities. I would encourage each of you to get involved, and it's never too soon or too late. Health in New Zealand in the 21st century faces many challenges, some of which will need the leadership of the professions to which all of you have now joined. When I look back over the last 25 years, I see contemporaries who've gone on to become leaders in health, not only in the clinical area, but in education and research and in governance. Some were late bloomers, particularly in the more non-clinical areas, but their list of achievements is long and significant. Have no doubt that amongst you sit leaders, and it may in fact be you. Always strive to look at smarter ways to work, strive to give back to this wonderful profession and to the public we serve. Trust in the knowledge that you have been well trained. When many of you travel overseas and work, you will realise just what a superb education you have had. Be proud of this, but more importantly, be humble enough to want to return and give back. So to you, the graduates of the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences, I offer my warmest congratulations. I wish you a successful day of celebrating for those due at ward rounds tomorrow at Middlemore, not too much. And I look forward to seeing you grow and succeed in your chosen fields. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Mr. Connolly, for a very interesting speech and some wise counsel. Having had a doctor for a father, I recognised some of the advice that you were giving. Can I ask you again to show your appreciation, please, to Mr. Connolly? This is a meeting of council and convocation of the university for a ceremony of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. At this ceremony, the Pro-Chancellor, Ian Parton, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I now invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
Thank you, Chancellor. By the authority vested in me, by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Pro-Chancellor, confer the degrees and award the diplomas stated upon those who, within their faculty, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences, Professor Martin, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences. Diploma in Paediatrics, Danusha Ellen Young. To the degree of Bachelor of Health Sciences, Ruth Frances Aston. Shivanthi Kumari Balala. Neely Irene Barker. Daniel Michael Burge. Shisheng Kai. Ashmita Chand. Wan Chin Chang. Rebecca Robin Crichton. Amosa Junior Edwards. Kalasita Nami Fale. Yuan Gong. Fakaosi Junior Hausia. Haimata Maitana Napia Tiana Herman. Kelly Louise Bonnie Hunt. Ryan Jonathan Hunt. Kalpuna Maheshi Jayanatha. Carissa Joy, Senior Scholar in Population Health. Pai Fen Lee. Hitesh Prasad Lokan. Mary Adley Ayad Locker. Lynn Tau Mariette McFarland. Devuksha Naidu. Rochelle Cardine Newport. Yvonne Yuen Ng. Monique Arena Palaoni. Roxana Mary Paracha. Sheena Patel. Melita Allison Rigamoto. Monica Sammy. Junti Tak. Tamar Naomi Tuilagi. Antonia Claire Verstappen. Jung Lan Yang. To the degree of Bachelor of Medicine and Bachelor of Surgery, Ahmed Nuriman bin Ahmed Nazir. Mele Vangana Amanki. Sarah Jane Ashcroft. Timothy Glenn Askeland. Nora Fika Binti Ayub. Mohammed Najib Aziz. John Barnett. Angela Audrey Bailey. Meron Charmaine Yulin Bennett. Cynthia Francis Benny. Sarah Jane Benson Cooper. Sarah Catherine Bowie. Oliver James Rawlinson Brake. Holly Eleanor Britton. Anthony David Buddle. Cameron Robert Burton. James Andrew Campbell. Alexandra Claire Cardinal. Chan Kin Chung. Mary Emma Imelda Changwai. Rini Sojanaya Chegudi. Joseph Chi Yung Chen. Jamie Wenji Chung. Lisa Karen Dawes. Manika Kawadu Janani Kashlaya Da Silva, Senior Scholar in Medicine and Surgery. Pranali Shashank Desai. Andrew Jeffrey Duffin. Izar Haswani Zulkifli. Sarah Grace Edmonds. Malindra Clive Ilikatugi Fernando. Jenny Fu. Jeremy John Fison. Victoria Pamela Gates. Brian Thomas Granger. Noel Teresa Greentree. Florence Adna Gunawan. Vit Hemstapat. Norman Melville Henley. Jonathan Ernest Henry. Thomas Andrew Edmund Hurd. Doran Jeffrey Hickey, Wolf Fisher Scholar. Rebecca Christine Higgins, Senior Scholar in Medicine and Surgery. Dominique Simone Hitti. Chester Percival Holt Quick. Timothy Alexander Hopgood. Kok Chung Ho. Kate Ida Hudig. Mary Hung. Shafiq bin Hussein. Amy Catherine Irons. Joel Otto Jackson. Kalpa Thorindu Jayanatha. Vikram Abraham Joseph. Bryce Wenatia Alan Kirini. Hannah Kim. Ji Young Kim. Rebecca Jane Lamb. Kilistina Kolakilalova Lavolu. Gaylene Labar. Sophie Elizabeth Leach. Nicola Lilich. David Kwai Leong Lim. William Lin. Kalpana Loganath. Matororia Potiki Linden. Copper Gabriel Manahi. Lynette McGoffrin. Rachel Sarah McMahon. Rebecca Margaret Meffin. Milica Milinovic. Salina Binti Mohammed Iyaz. Mohammed Talib Mojood. Mohammed Havitsi bin Mohammed Nazir. Gwenda Orlean Dahlia Tokilioto Napi. Dorisha Naika. Kavendra Naidu. Duncan Andrew Nielsen. Jared Mark Noel. Yishin Oi. Alistair Torfilau Papali Curtin. Mariam Patel. Sarah Faye Penaligan. Tarina Ta'aho Pollock. Adele Joanna Pope. Kate Elizabeth Rapson. Aritra Ray. Genevieve Catherine Rayner. Najiha Razali. Susan Caroline Reeder. Jason Paul Robertson. Matthew Byron Rao. Cheryl Leah Ruarau. Claire Russell. Peter Spencer Russell. Archana Selva Kumar. Sriharan Selva Ratnam. Robert Yue Shuao. Yai Wan Shin. Rebecca Jasmine Shine. Natalia Sojadi. Victoria Kate Stiebel. Matthew William John Street. Michael John Stubbs. Trin Quach Su. Syed Mohammed bin Syed Abdul Hamid. Hoikiat Tan. Yu Mi Tan, Senior Scholar in Medicine and Surgery. Amanda Marie Taylor, Senior Scholar in Medicine and Surgery. Leah Francis DeWeehy. Sei Ying Tay. Amelia Fetoliamoa ta Fonogafiafoa Tetikitiki. Andrea Jane Thomas. Jenny Marie Matoi Thomas. Mele Lola Tupo. Ursula Vandenhever. Samuel Poriana Wall. Wan Noor Hafizar Binti Wan Baharuddin. Millie Yu Wang. Luke Kalihua Ward. Emily Fuanala Macrina Webster. Casey Ann Wedekind. Delanga Kushalan Wirakodi. Madeline Margaret Wells. Catherine Louise White. Ditlendra Rasith Wijanayaka. Jonathan Robert Arthur Wills. Wai Kiat Wong. Wei Lung Wong. Peter Allen Wood. William Zeng. To the degree of Bachelor of Nursing, Da Yon Bai. Katrina Marie Bennett. Curry Danny Bryers. Luke Douglas Burgess. Judith Alice Burnett. Emerald Briar Campbell. Jenny I Chung Chen. Grace Carmel Cobol Chu. Amy Louise Cryer. Elise Alexandra Michelle Davies. Jefferson DeRay. Leanne Ashita D'Souza. Megan Joan Elliott. Alexandra Fife, Senior Scholar in Nursing. Carla Christine Joyce Agena Gonda. Sarah Nicola Good. Baia Hamala. Kerry Lynn Hutchings. Andrew Goodwin Jones. Hyun Soo Jung. Sophie Alexandra Knight. Alice Lee. Dong Yuan Lee. Ying Lee. Janet Ting Ting Liu. Samuel Desmond Loughran. Kristen Jane Lovell. Suzette Rose McClellan. Emma Kate Miller. Mayanaz Mozadeg. Janine Myers. Chan Mi O. Liana Deborah Penny. Chloe Grace Christine Pennell. Natalie Claire Sargon. Tui Shanti Sion. Stephanie Sequeira, Senior Scholar in Nursing. Miral Rohit Shah. Jan Nadine Manasala Siebel. Caroline Susan Sneha. Jasmine Bell Snoswell. Phoebe Joyce Stone. Sarah Kate Swanivelder. Moirungi Roma Holder Tarmati. Latu Kelani Ta'afo. Mary Scott Tom. Liji Mariam Thomas. Anne Elizabeth Thompson. Esme Marie Thornhill. Yan Ha Marina Tong. Maud Beatrice Tuzel. Joanne Wonrong Tsai. Talatiga Tutagalevo. Elizabeth Lacey Usher. Amanda Hope Van Royen. Karen Carpo Wu. Nikki Segui Yero. Barishna Zara. to the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy with First Class Honours, J. Anna Courtney Brewster. Kwan Min Jackie Chan. Kaylee Ann Naidu. Lina Penn. Richard Thomas Perry. Holly Murray Signal. Harjinder Kaur Singh. Sachin Sunil Thakur. Kunsala Tamali Diaz Samawik Rama Yapa. To the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy with Second Class Honours, First Division, Aisha Sheshita Ali. Rachel Lauren Blackburn. Cassandra K. Butler. Lisa Chang. Bliss Chia Tsu Yin. Aiping Cheng. Tonya Kate Clark. Carmen Dai. Katie Lauren Davis. Mary Helen Gubb. Dahlia Hassan. Yun Duk Hong. Sophie Marie Jones. Xu Teng Kan. Yuping Gao. Rita Ketuola. Jess Lynn Lee. Yu Young Lee. Edwin Eng Kian Lim. Winnie Yi Sing Ling. Stephanie Sime Lau. Yujun Lu. Ishmael Fathi is Ishmael Fatahi. Last one.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding diplomas in the first half of the ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Natalie Harris on clarinet and Dean Skye Lucas on piano will now perform the third movement, Allegro con fuoco, from the Sonata for Clarinet and Piano by Francis Poulenc. Thank you, Natalie and Dean. It's quite an energetic piece of music, and I couldn't help thinking how we might appreciate it again about 9:30 this evening, but it was beautifully played, and can I ask you all to show your appreciation again? Each year we have some memorable performances like that from students in our School of Music, and if you would like to hear further such performances, the graduation concert will be held tomorrow evening, Thursday, at 7:30 in the Town Hall. All graduates and their families are invited to attend, and admission is free. By the authority vested in me, by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Roger France, Chancellor, confer the degrees and award the diplomas stated upon those who within their faculty have satisfied the requirements of this university.
To the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy with Second Class Honours, First Division, Anisha Kaur Sandhu. Sorry? To the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy with Second Class Honours, First Division, Priscilla Hawa Mock Park. To the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy with Second Class Honours, First Division, Anisha Kaur Sandhu. Lisa Mays Shabbat. Jessica Ling Tan. Rebecca May Taylor. Piset To. Janil Shao Chu Tsai. Dylan Nai An Wu. Ming Yang. Karen Yu. Shou Yuan Zhong. Ziheng Zhu. To the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Zainab Thama Abdul Muzin. Maina Adaim. Lenati Takai Aho. Ibrahim Al Mudalal. Callum Fraser Tiansi Anderson. Natalie Marie Antill. Gina George Sobi Azair Iskander. Lee Yung Chang. Tony Tung An Chang. Navyan Diwan. Amanda Lee Eichstead. Cheng Xiao Go. Ling Phi Derek Cam. Sandeep Kaur. Ravnet Krishan Lal. Eric S.Y. Lee. Kwang Chung Lu. Ben Manuson. Jing Miao. Tian Ling Nguyen. Hannah Park. Rebecca Park. Belinda Jane Robinson. Sally Selek. Yu-Wei So. Sarah Joy Wilkinson. Chung Man Mandy Wong. Lun Sheng Wong. Chloe Wong Tsu Mei. Rebecca Zoe Woodrow. Yifei Yang. Su Yu Ye. Dan Yu. To the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy, Fadiya Arif Abdul Khalik Alabusuisi. Richard Tin Yao Chan. Enmiao Chang. Amy Moon Jung Kim. Damian Francis Mihek. Wan Ho No. Tasha Mary Reiner. Amanda Tew. Timothy Tin Man Young. Ju He Yu. To the degree of Bachelor of Health Sciences, conjoint, Daniela Catherine De Terry Bell and a Bachelor of Arts. Wan Ying Valerie Chan and a Bachelor of Arts. Jessica Hung Yi Kwok and a Bachelor of Arts. Kimberly Daniela Marie Maxwell and a Bachelor of Arts. Tiana Misur and a Bachelor of Commerce. Louise Elizabeth Walker and a Bachelor of Arts. Leo Rene Wijaratne and a Bachelor of Commerce. to the degree of Bachelor of Nursing, conjoint, Catherine Jane Carey, and a Bachelor of Science. Amy Carissa Rutland, and a Bachelor of Science. Alina Zofia Wiptich, and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Postgraduate Diploma in Clinical Education. Kerry Leslie Lum. Postgraduate Diploma in Community Emergency Medicine, Shahrukh Al Ansari. Postgraduate Diploma in Health Sciences with Distinction, Claire Allison Hatherell in Advanced Nursing. Melanie Jane Lanigan in Advanced Nursing. Postgraduate Diploma in Health Sciences with Merit, Beverly Gay Bedford in Advanced Nursing. Catherine Bennett in Mental Health Nursing. Hannah Elizabeth Cataway in Advanced Nursing. Dana D'Souza in Advanced Nursing. Sharon Joyce Iseli. Rositsa Stoyanova Jelitsikova in Advanced Nursing. Honey Cecilia Marsh in Advanced Nursing. Sini Parikattal Chakapan in Advanced Nursing. Shaviki Sharma in Mental Health Nursing. Postgraduate Diploma in Health Sciences, Sarah Jane Allen in Advanced Nursing. Karen Eve Brown in Mental Health Nursing. Letitia Peggy Ruth Burkhart in Advanced Nursing. Geeta Shivani Chandra in Advanced Nursing. Leah Marie Dixon. Lisi Fualagi in Advanced Nursing. Daryl Jane Francis in Advanced Nursing. Yuwen Huang. Mohammed Kabir Husseini. Selani Ayolu in Advanced Nursing. Dorothy Tsitsi Jamela in Advanced Nursing. Roberta Ray Kayo in Mental Health Nursing. Malvina Kumar in Advanced Nursing. Manchi Kwok in Advanced Nursing. Supriya Maharaj. Gillian Margaret Martin in Advanced Nursing. Catherine Crossan McClymont in Advanced Nursing. Kahui De Copa Neho in a Mental Health Nursing. Marie Niklumwama. Theresa Ngu in mental health nursing. Bernadette Veronica Penny in health informatics. Mary Charlotte Roberts in advanced nursing. Cheryl Mary Ann Roberts in advanced nursing. Namala Sami in advanced nursing. Taufimalo Sapolo in mental health nursing. Deborah Rosalind Mary Sharma in social work. Kamal Nan Singh in advanced nursing. Postgraduate Diploma in Māori Health, Roseanne Janice Young. Postgraduate Diploma in Pharmacy Practice with Distinction, Elizabeth Ann Oliphant. Postgraduate Diploma in Public Health with Merit, Gillian Kaur Balbia Singh. Siobhan Fa'avar Duffy in Pacific Health. Edith Forrester. Edith. Natasha Tanya Go. Jennifer Francis Johnson. Vicky Louise Masson. Leah Adrid Palapa. Jayshree Ramesh Sukkar. Ruta Josephine Stevenson to Ugar in Pacific Health. Postgraduate Diploma in Public Health, Andrea Margaret Bidwar. Pankti Kansara. Saini Taumafalau Manu Opa Nayi. Janice Jiwon Park. Michael Vincent Walker. To the degree of Bachelor of Health Sciences Honours with First Class Honours. Sam Emmanuel. Jed Horner. Runmali Bella Navida Nalagani Priyananthi Jayasinghe. Amanda Rochelle Wood. Cheng Husui Yi. To the degree of Bachelor of Health Sciences Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division, Delia Katouros. Lyres Mai Reston Freeth and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. J. Jenny Gautam, University Graduate Scholar. To the degree of Bachelor of Human Biology Honours with First Class Honours, Kylie Ellen Edwards, and a Bachelor of Medicine and a Bachelor of Surgery. To the degree of Bachelor of Medical Science Honours with First Class Honours, Sukhdeer Singh in Medical Science, University Graduate Scholar. To the degree of Bachelor of Nursing Honours with First Class Honours, Gemma Elizabeth Oban. To the degree of Bachelor of Nursing Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division, Marie-Chris Dela Cruz Gabasan. To the degree of Master of Clinical Education, Wayne Anthony De Beer. Peter Charles Fleischel. To the degree of Master of Health Management with First Class Honours, Matthew Jason Glasgow. To the degree of Master of Health Sciences with First Class Honours, Alexandra Faye Graham Boyle. Rachel Ann Butler. Si Yu Luong. Keng Chi Lu. Smita Ravi Tiparaju. To the degree of Master of Health Sciences with Second Class Honours, First Division, Vera Sabine Barr. Manju Bashahini Kanamala and a Postgraduate Diploma in Health Sciences with Merit in Pharmaceutical Science. Claire Samantha Mays. Jamie Martin Robinson, and a Graduate Diploma in Health Sciences. Amanda Marlene Smith. Barbara Vale. Tanya Michelle Waitokia. Claire Louise Whitehead. To the degree of Master of Health Sciences with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Jainesh Shyamal Sharma. To the degree of Master of Health Sciences, Alexandra Fiona Hewardine. Dinah Fakararo Smith. To the degree of Master of Nursing with First Class Honours, Rosemary Adrian Coates. Renee Susan Edwards. Catherine Ann Fleckney. Brian David Gibberson, and a Postgraduate Diploma in Health Sciences with Distinction in Advanced Nursing. Louise Leonard, and a Postgraduate Diploma in Health Sciences with Merit in Mental Health Nursing. Yeah. Helen Therese O'Shaughnessy. To the degree of Master of Nursing with Second Class Honours, First Division, Josephine Elizabeth Ann Davis Wheaton. To the degree of Master of Nursing with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Bridget Mary Killian, and a Postgraduate Diploma in Health Sciences in Advanced Nursing. Elaine Joyce MacDonald. Vicky Coral Thompson. To the degree of Master of Public Health with First Class Honours, Karen Marie Bartholomew, and a Postgraduate Diploma in Public Health with Distinction. Deborah Susan Hay. Sarah Jane Hood, and a Postgraduate Diploma in Public Health. Catherine Mary Jackson. Louise Bernadette McCarthy. Amy May Rensford. Christy Jane Truatha. To the degree of Master of Public Health with Second Class Honours, First Division, Sian Burgess. Bradley David Clark. Jennifer Naomi Nahamaya Mungaherrera. Nuran Raghaban. Nicola Ivy Valiluaga Ta'ave. To the degree of Master of Public Health with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Kartiga Kanishar. Soana Moi Moi Hiata.
I now call upon the Vice Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Pharmacy, John Allen Dunlop. John investigated the practicalities of having clinical pharmacists work closely with heart failure patients to reduce the incidence of drug-related illness and improve their health status by optimising medication profiles. His research highlighted the need to develop collaborative relationships between general practitioners and clinical pharmacists by working together in the general practice environment. John. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Catherine Jane Askeland in Obstetrics and Gynaecology, University Doctoral Scholar, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. Catherine investigated the mechanisms leading to the death of cell fragments of the placenta, called syncytial knots, that are shed into the maternal blood during pregnancy, and how these fragments may help to protect the placenta and fetus from the maternal immune system. Her work may help us to understand the causes of diseases of pregnancy, such as recurrent miscarriage and preeclampsia. Ursula Therese Evely Byrne in Anatomy and Pharmacology. Ursula has demonstrated that myeloperoxidase, an enzyme which makes a toxic bleach substance, may contribute to the loss of neurons seen in Alzheimer's disease. Inhibition of myeloperoxidase in the brain may represent a novel therapeutic strategy for Alzheimer's disease. Kenny Kwok Hin Chong in Physiology, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. Kenny investigated the role of specific cell membrane channels contributing to nerve cell damage in Parkinson's disease. Kenny. Joanne Davidson in Physiology and Anatomy, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. Joanne investigated the role of the connections between cells in spreading brain injury and in triggering abnormal activity in the developing brain. By blocking these connections for a short time after a period of low blood flow, she was able to safely improve recovery of brain activity and reduce seizures, confirming that these channels play a key role in extending brain injury. Helen Christine Isles in Community Health. Helen explored the effects of tailored nutrition education on household supermarket food purchases in a diverse New Zealand population. Her findings suggest that approaches to improving population diets should include structural as well as individual behaviour change strategies. Peter Stuart Freestone in Physiology, University Doctoral Scholar. Peter investigated the cellular mechanisms of nerve cell damage by neurotoxins in models of Parkinson's disease. Stephen Philip Jacobs in Medicine. Stephen developed a systematic process for health service funders and planners to use when developing and delivering new community health services for older people. Isuru Dilshan Jayasinghe in Physiology. Isuru investigated fundamental aspects of the distribution of proteins in heart muscle cells and revealed pictures with unprecedented detail. His work has opened the door to an improved understanding of structural changes that accompany heart failure. Elizabeth Jane Kiata Holland in General Practice. Elizabeth explored the everyday experiences of older adults living in a New Zealand rest home context to understand how residents made meaning in their day-to-day lives. The study findings reveal that the elders continue to participate in and actively manage satisfactory and fulfilling pastimes and relationships in their everyday life worlds. Andrew James Marshall in Molecular Medicine. Andrew investigated the mechanisms by which inhibitors of the enzyme PI3 kinase can specifically target different isoforms of this enzyme. Catherine Kahu McClintock in Psychiatry. Kahu investigated some of the fundamental engagement processes based on whānau involvement and cultural respect needed to support Māori child and adolescent mental health service users. David Grant McNamara in Paediatrics. David investigated whether using a heated humidifier to provide enhanced level of warmth and moisture improved the health of children with tracheostomies. David. Laura Elizabeth Myers in Community Health. Laura developed an innovative approach for assessing the needs of disabled people and quantifying the resources required to live and thrive in our communities. Laura. Anubhav Mittal in Surgery, University Doctoral Scholar. Anubhav investigated three novel concepts in relation to acute pancreatitis. Cyclic voltammetry adapted from the wine industry for the real-time measurement of oxidative stress, the protein composition of mesenteric lymph to define the basis for its toxicity, and mitochondrial dysfunction in end organs prone to failure in severe pancreatitis. In Hyop Park in Pharmacology, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. In Hyop developed models of adult human brain neurogenesis to investigate some of the fundamental mechanisms of adult neurogenesis. It is hoped that these findings will aid in the development of therapies for neurodegenerative brain diseases. John Jeffrey Morgan Parsons in Health Sciences. John investigated the impact of a designated goal facilitation tool on health-related quality of life, social support, and physical function among a sample of community-dwelling older people referred for home care. The study findings have significant national and international implications for designing and implementing models of care to assist older people to remain independent in their own homes. Praniti Pathapati in Molecular Medicine. Praniti investigated the possibility of a long-term treatment for adult stroke and its effects on stem cells in the brain. Findings from these studies hold significance in the field of ischemic stroke and present promising candidates for the treatment of this devastating medical emergency. Catherine Ann Perry in Nursing. Kathy investigated the effects of an individualised physical activity program in improving the quality of life and function in residents of aged care facilities. Stephen Robert Ritchie in Molecular Medicine and Pathology. Stephen's research into human disease caused by Staphylococcus aureus has helped to explain why this bacterium affects Māori and Pacific people much more commonly than people of European or other ethnicities in Auckland. Darren Michael Sversky's in Pharmacy. Darren explored the use of the conducting polymer, polypyrrol, to achieve modifiable release of the antipsychotic drug risperidone. This technology could be utilised in implantable drug delivery systems where the dose could be adjusted by external signalling, optimising patient benefit to side effect ratios while simultaneously ensuring compliance. Carmel Jane Williams in Community Health. Carmel used a health and human rights framework to develop tools that can be used to guide the design of aid-funded health programs and to ensure that health aid is effective, appropriate, and does no harm. Her work translates the right to health into practice, has direct application to aid programs delivered in our Pacific region, and draws on her work in Papua New Guinea.
To the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy with Second Class Honours, First Division, Ahmed Ismail Fathi Mohammed Marmoush.
And in absentia, all those other persons named in the Book of Convocation qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences.
Teaching Excellence Awards. The university places considerable significance on excellence in teaching. It recognises this by making awards each year to teachers who have demonstrated excellence in aspects of teaching. These awards are contestable across the university and signify a truly superior achievement. An award for excellence in postgraduate research supervision has been made to Professor Louise Nicholson in the deanery within the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences. I now call upon a student of that faculty, Joanne Davidson, to read the citation for Professor Nicholson.
I am delighted to speak about Professor Louise Nicholson's excellence as a research supervisor. I am one of many who have undertaken the journey to doctoral completion under her guidance. Over 21 years, Louise has supervised students across the spectrum, from honours projects to doctorates. She provides them all with a stimulating and challenging environment. At the start, Louise carefully nurtures students, guiding the development of a clear research direction. She then allows them the freedom to develop and expand their skills and interests while providing carefully targeted support. Louise exercises a duty of care that is exceptional, always aware of any personal issues that might affect a student's ability to perform at his or her best. She provides wonderful support and directs students to other assistance as required. She works tirelessly to ensure that students gain access to international research leaders so they are able to pursue collaborative opportunities and to discuss future career options. As a result, Louise's students are found across the world, from Perth to Los Angeles, Auckland to Oxford and beyond. Former students frequently seek out Louise's advice and guidance as they chart their own careers. She is always willing to facilitate introductions and provide assistance to help them progress. Louise has also exercised faculty-wide leadership to develop an environment that supports young researchers. Her supports of initiatives such as HealthX and Chiasma assures students of the opportunities to present to a critical audience in a supportive environment. Louise exemplifies the successful researcher. She has enthusiasm, vigour, and passion that she imparts to her students, and is quite rightly held in the highest regard by them. They know what it is like to work with a staff member committed to ensuring that they achieve and succeed. It is a pleasure to present Louise Nicholson as a worthy recipient of a University of Auckland Teaching Excellence Award.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present a Fellow of the University of Auckland.
Better signal next time.
Just career limiting. Chancellor. I have pleasure in presenting to you Alison Patterson for the Ward of the Honour Fellow of the University of Auckland. Alison Patterson is being acknowledged today for her outstanding contribution to the University of Auckland through her role as the first chair of the board of the National Research Centre for Growth and Development, a centre of research excellence. Mrs. Patterson joined the Board of Governance of the centre at its inception in 2003 and has been the chair ever since. Her background is in corporate governance and leadership in the service and health industries. She has served as a director on numerous public sector and private organisation boards, including the board of the Reserve Bank, the Wrightson Board, chair of the board of Landcorp Farming Limited, chair of the Electricity Complaints Commission, and chair of Waitemata District Health Board. Alison is also a board member for another of the centres of research excellence hosted by the University of Auckland, Ngā Pae o te Maramatanga, and she is also a councillor of Massey University. This long history of excellence in governance has provided her with a breadth of experience and a wide range of skills. Indeed, in November 2003, Director magazine profiled Alison Patterson, calling her the consummate director. The National Research Centre for Growth and Development has a complex structure, with multiple partners geographically spread across the country. The board, under Alison's chairmanship, has therefore had to steer a course through a complicated structure of responsibilities and interests. The wide respect in which Alison is held, both by fellow members of the board and by members of the centre, reflects not only her abilities as chair of the board, but also her clear and genuine commitment to the centre and her desire to see it succeed and excel as a centre of research excellence. Alison Patterson has devoted a great deal of time, energy and skills to the governance of the centre and to the members, taking her role as chair of the board very seriously and investing significant personal energy into ensuring the centre's success. She has taken a large administrative workload between meetings and has always made herself widely available to the executive team of the centre. This has extended to regular face-to-face meetings between board meetings, frequent contact and constant availability by telephone and email, even when on holiday overseas. Alison has taken it upon herself to consult widely with members of the centre, including travelling to the various geographical locations so that she can meet personally with investigators. Alison has been an active champion for the National Research Centre for Growth and Development, both within the University of Auckland and in the wider community. She has been proactive in seeking engagement with chairs of the boards of other centres of research excellence and also with government. The commitment that Alison has played as Chair of the Board of Governance of the National Research Centre for Growth and Development has ensured that it has a solid foundation on which to continue to grow, and which will ensure its ongoing success as a centre of research excellence. Chancellor, university fellowships are awarded to those who make a unique and valuable contribution to the university. Alison Patterson's contribution has undoubtedly been both unique and valuable. I am therefore delighted to present her to you for the award of a fellowship of the University of Auckland.
On behalf of the university, can I now invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. And it is unlikely you will get a better opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they have achieved their qualifications. This concludes this meeting of Council and Convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori and then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of the programmes.